here in Singapore, removing the age limit for women to access in vitro fertilization was among five recommendations made in a position paper from the PAP Women's Wing. The six MPs were tasked with looking into how to raise Singapore's fertility rate.
The recommendations follow a survey of more than 2,000 respondents, and Deborah Wong tells us more.
Currently, women above 45 are not allowed to receive IVF in Singapore due to lower success rates and medical complications. But advancements in fertility treatments have lowered the risk for older women. Places like the UK, Australia and Hong Kong have already removed the age limit for such treatments. And the proposals from MPs are calling for Singapore to follow suit.
The reality is that we are faced with a demographic who are marrying later. So that's something that we have to acknowledge and give support.
When asked if this move will encourage families to have children later, the MP said that they were aware that this could send a wrong signal about the likelihood of success. They have suggested that the Health Ministry review the proposal and provide appropriate funding for those whose chances of conception are good. They also added that this move will give older women more options should they wish to start families later.
Despite a wide range of subsidies, the MPs found that cost is a deal breaker for many to raise a child. For example, households with less than $12,000 monthly household income tend to spend up to 15% on preschool fees per child, and this is after subsidies. There are also out-of-pocket expenses like extracurricular activities and excursions. The MPs have suggested capping the spending to 5% of household income to bring costs down. They also suggested expanding the anchor and partner preschool operator schemes so that at least 80% of households can get access to affordable childcare within a 10-minute walk. These operators get funding support to lower fees.
Maybe bring more other operators into that scheme so that the overall level of fees in the entire industry is lower. Second is, what more can we do on the subsidies front? Perhaps the income brackets have to be raised to see how we can support even more families with more subsidies.
Another recommendation was to understand the needs of different industries and jobs and come up with various solutions to promote flexible work arrangements. Respondents said workplace flexibility could influence family planning decisions. And for this to work, the MP said employers and workers should do their part to promote a trusted workplace culture. And for families with special needs children, the MPs have proposed strengthening the sense of inclusion. This means providing equal opportunities to learn and grow. The position paper will be submitted to the government for consideration.